so impressed today by our community, and that's not unusual here in Richmond. We are Richmond.
Tonight, a city is standing strong after an active shooter situation at a school. I'm Amanda Starn, Tino.
And I'm Mark Mullins. Tonight, the teen accused of firing shots at Dennis Intermediate School in Richmond is dead.
And all of the students in the building are okay. We are live in Richmond with teen coverage of the new developments coming in.
We begin with Rafael Sanchez, live outside of Dennis Intermediate School. Rafael, what are you learning this evening?
Mark and Amanda, good evening. As you can see behind me, a police command center is still here on the scene. But let me take you to the image that is the most eye-opening of the day. This is the front door of Dennis Intermediate School here in Richmond. The 14-year-old, we're told, used a gun to burst through the front door by shooting through the glass door to get into the school. Now, the school was ready for this incident because someone had called in earlier in the day, and that saved lives today. We're told that the 14-year-old is not a student of the school. We now begin our live team coverage with our Nicole Griffin, who's just a couple of feet away from me by that front door. Nicole?
Well, Rafael, this is the area where police came in contact with that 14-year-old suspect. This is Peacock Road, right on the side of Dennis Intermediate near 7th Street. Tonight, the glass door where that student broke in is still broken tonight. And I'm told state police investigators are still inside at this very hour collecting evidence. Now, police credit a person who notified them ahead of time of what this teenager planned to do for saving lives today. They aren't releasing who made that notification, but tell us that person is having a difficult time tonight. We do know the suspect was not a current student here. We also know officers with Richmond Police and the Wayne County Sheriff's Office, as well as a state trooper, were here on scene before the student made it inside the school. They knew who they were looking for and confronted him, and that's when he fired those shots into the door as the school was on lockdown. Officers quickly went inside the building after that suspect. Police say gunfire was exchanged between the teenager and officers. It's not clear tonight if an officer hit the suspect, but police say the teenager did take his own life. We talked to people living right across the street who watched all of this unfold this morning.
I just saw the kid dressed in all black, and he had a big old look like gun case, and he climbed in the bottom of the door when they shot the glass out.
We heard the two shots, and so we immediately looked out the window, and I didn't really see anybody go into the school, but I saw there was already cops out front on the street.
Witnesses out here at that time describe this scene as pure panic. That is because many of the people who live right here along this street have students that attend Dennis Intermediate School. Now tonight, the mayor telling us that everyone fears every day that this could happen in their community, and today is that day for Richmond. Reporting live, Nicole Griffin, RTV6. Rafael, now back to you.
Nicole, thank you so much. Still no motive, and the name of that suspect will not be released by police just yet. All evening activities at the elementary and intermediate schools have been canceled. As you can see behind me, this is a residential neighborhood, and tonight parents are having some tough discussions about what happened at the school across the street. Our Alyssa Donovan has more.
Just after 12 p.m., after hours of waiting, parents and children were reunited here at Richmond High School.
Were you hiding in a classroom?
Under a desk.
Under a desk, she said.
Krista Tate finally holding her 14-year-old daughter.
I'm just having that text from your daughter. It says, "You're the best mom in the world. I don't know if I'm going to see you again, but I love you." I don't even remember the ride here. I'm just happy to be able to hug her.
But before this moment, parents were frantic and frustrated, pacing outside of the Civic Center at Richmond High School, the designated spot to pick up their Dennis Intermediate School students.
I just want to get my hands around my granddaughter. That's all.
And all we want to know is that all our babies are okay, and I just want her, I want her home.
Christopher Bryant waited for his son and his wife, who works at the school. Both were inside at the time of the shooting.
She let me know that, everything was okay, and she was a little hysterical, which is meant to be, but, the children are fine.
Many parents in contact with their children via cell phones.
My little girl texted me, told me she was scared. We just got her transferred to school. We just moved into the location. That's what's even so crazy. So I'm asking her why, and she said they're shooting.
Up next for these families, how to discuss this trauma with their kids.
My tactic is going to be just let her express her feelings and how she's feeling and just reassuring her that it's going to be okay.
In Richmond, Alyssa Donovan, RTV6.
Every school in our state has a school safety plan. Our Derek Thomas tonight on why Richmond was ready.
It did take over 2 hours for some parents to finally retrieve their children. And those children had a story to tell.
Because I was scared that someone was going to get very injured or could have died.
Now, what did the teacher tell you?
Just to be quiet and stay calm.
Apparently, the drills and the plan the district has put in place worked.
And I'm proud to say that our teachers responded appropriately, our staff members responded appropriately, our students responded appropriately. And that's not by chance. That's because they have taken these drills seriously. Our community understands the importance of that. And they did the right things today.
School board member Deborah Moore praised the way the school district handled the situation. She had two grandchildren at Dennis Intermediate.
They did an amazing job executing this to make sure that not one kid was in danger, not one staff member was in danger. Everybody did what they were supposed to do, got the kids out, and it was amazing. It was just a great plan.
That didn't keep her granddaughter from having a little anxiety.
But you could hear them shooting, and I thought it was like somebody banging against the lockers to scare us so that we don't scream, but it was actual shooting.
Yes, it was. At 6 o'clock, we will tell you the story of a mother who has identical triplets that were inside the school and how she responded and her boys responded to the school shooting.
That was Derek Thomas reporting. You know, since May, when we were at Noblesville West Middle School and that school shooting there, RTV6 has been committed to the issue of school safety. We have a special site on our website, theindychannel.com, and the RTV6 app dedicated to what schools across the region are doing to keep your child safe. You can take a look at that section of our website and you can see what different schools are doing to make sure children are safe every single day while they are in with those teachers in their respective school systems. And Mark and Amanda, you know, today someone speaking up made a difference. So often some kids call it snitching or tattletaling. That's not true. When you speak up, you are courageous. When you speak up, you are courageous as well, and you made a difference. You saved lives today. So we hope that the big lesson today is if you see something, say something, because someone doing that today saved many lives, and that person is a hero.
Rafael, that's right. We don't call it snitching. We call it saving lives. Rafael Sanchez, live for us tonight in Richmond.
Saving lives.